Okay, gotta get the cat started. Gotta get the blade back on it. We need it for a couple days on this farm cleanup job we're doing. And we're supposed to get a bunch of snow this morning. And it's colder than a well digger's butt. So I got the truck going. I gotta get this going. We gotta get it. The blade put back on, the hood put back on, ripper shanks in it. And then this is gonna, just gonna have to wait another week before we can get it in the shop and get working on it, dang it. But that's just the way it is. Oh, I didn't turn the key on. Yes, I did. Why aren't we glow plugs are working. Starter's not though. Damn it. Oh, great. Now I gotta fix that. Okay, I have tracked the problem down. It's the heat start switch. It'll heat the glow plugs in this position, but it will not start. There's no juice coming out of the switch on the start side, so it's this switch that's kaput. So what I'm gonna have to do is heat the glow plugs. Then I've got to go outside here on the starter. And I've got me a short piece of wire cut. And I'm going to have to start it the hard way. Oh, balls. winter's back again today. It's 7 degrees here. It's warmed up a little since the sun's come up, but we got some more storm coming, I guess. We're supposed to get another 1 to 3 inches. Just to the north of me, up in Island Park, West Yellowstone, it's below zero. Old Knox Pilati invited me up there to West Yellowstone this weekend to go sledding. And I really wanted to, but I just had a million things I had to get done. And kind of glad I didn't go, because it was a hell of a storm Sunday up there, I guess. I haven't talked to him to see what it was like when he was sledding up there, but sure appreciate you inviting me up there, Knox. I would love to go snowmobiling with you sometime. I kept thinking about calling you in, and since we didn't have a lot of snow down here, about coming up to Bozeman. So anyway, this weekend, Taylor and I are probably going to go up to Island Park to go sledding. It's his birthday, and they have a lot of new snow, so. But I've got to get this job done. I gotta finish getting this swamp pushed in. And then I can go play, I guess. Oh, I gotta get a video done too. This is Tuesday morning and I haven't done squat on a video, because I've been working, man. Oh, and the starter on the cat decided to start working again. I don't know why. The heat start switch decided to start working. Let's see if it'll go this morning. Okay, heat start switch ain't gonna work again today, so we're gonna have to do her the hard way. Gonna have to heat it and jump it. Touch this and this without creating a firestorm. Come on, baby, come on. Using a screwdriver to start this old girl in the morning, so I had Matt pick me up a new heat start switch, and I'm gonna install it tonight while it's still warm in here. It's actually quite nice in here with all that heat coming up off the floor. Getting dark. Come on, Jeff. Okay, Jeff, don't drop the screw. Whatever you do, don't drop the screw. Get it started. Don't drop the screw. Thank you. Now, does it work though? Should we find out? Yep. It works.
Talk about some awesome subscribers. Let's go.
Hey, everybody. Want to talk about some awesome subscribers again this week? Want to start out with my Australian friends. Love my Australian subscribers. Knackers61. Don't know where you're from in Australia, but I know you're from Australia, mate. And Wally Hart. He's also from Australia. Thanks for subscribing, Wally. David Gorringe from South Devon, England. Thanks for subscribing, Devon. And the Ninja Pumpkin from Edmonton, Alberta. And Danny Hill. Let me show you a picture of Danny Hill and his truck. He's from Calgary. And he has introduced my channel to several of his friends. One of them, it's his cousin, Bolt Venture. I'm sure that's not his name, but I appreciate that, Danny. You recommended me to those people. That's awesome. I love that.
Ion Racer from Schertz, Texas. And Keenan Kelly, he's from Sedgwick, Kansas. And Demon Red, 1957. Thank you guys for subscribing. Oh, on a side note, I got this letter from YouTube. This sounds serious. This is on their official letterhead. I want to read this to you. Dear Jpaydirt, you needs some more people's subscribing to use channel, or will demonetize you and delete use videos. Sincerely, YouTubes. So please share Jpaydirt before they demonetize my channel and deletes all my videos. So I got a package from my good friends from Petaluma, my gabagoo friends. Glenn sent me something. This ain't gonna explode, is it, Glenn? I got a package from the Dons. I got a package from Don Gelati.
I'm all gelatied up, Glenn.
Remember that one? I'm all gelatied up.
Well, Glenn, you just go ahead and send me some business cards. I'm all gelatied up here. When I put this shirt and hat on today and went into McDonald's, I thought, somebody sees me, they're going to say, well, Jeff, you work for, who's this gelati outfit? You work for them now? That's why you texted me this morning and told me you had a good day. You knew what was coming.
FedEx! More hats from the head office. You need to get me some business cards that say Jeff Anderson, Idaho Division of Team Gelati. That's awesome. Ooh, a coat this time, a jacket. Sweet. Awesome. Love it, Glenn. Thank you. Now when I go to McDonald's, I can put on my shirt, my gelati shirt, my gelati hat, and my gelati jacket. And then people say, Jeff, you working for this gelati outfit? When I come down there, I'm going to have to put all this stuff on, walk in the office and say, yeah, Jeff Anderson from the Idaho office. I'd like to look at the books, please. I'd like to know where my check is. Where's my check? Thanks, Glenn. Oh, almost forgot. Thanks a lot.
They can't be done. We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound, just watch old Bandit run.
Here's some cool pictures from a subscriber down under, Kerry Gleason. He says, hi Jeff, a couple of work photos from out in the Australian bush as a young man on the dozer. Yes, a Fiat. Well, you know what Fiat stands for, don't you there, Kerry? That's Fix It Again Tony. Not a cat, 49 years ago. I am 70 next year. 2000 delivering a new truck from Melbourne to Port Hedland, 2,850 mile trip, trying to pass a road train. He has, I think, 84 wheels, his top speed about 59 miles per hour. My top speed 62 miles an hour, so I need close to 2 miles to get past him. These guys will not back off for anyone. It's their idea of entertainment, watching you trying to get past, and I'm hoping nothing appears coming the other way. If so, you either brake or drop back or flash your lights and hope the truck coming backs off a little. Either way, it's just very entertaining for the guy in the road train. If you can see his mirror, he will just have a big smile on his face. Keep up the great work. Regards, Kerry. Kerry, I gotta ask you, I had a subscriber that wanted to know why you guys run so many cab overs over there. This first one is from William Johnson, aka Bloop. William drove he hauled gas for 38 years. with the world's best, a KW, W900. L 72 Aero Cab. It's on my tombstone with a D6H, my wife's Corvette, all done by her before she lost a 4.5 year battle with cancer. Also, my dad ran a D9 most of his life. It says my pop working on I-65 around Bowling Green, Kentucky. That's awesome. Back when a man had to work hard. Okay, kids, guess what we're doing next week? You'll never guess. What are we doing? Stay tuned. It'll be exciting.